Well, let's summarize this instrumental variable regression topic. Video number 29 to video number 34, we have discussed what is instrumental variable, relevancy, exogeneity, F-test, J-test. Today I am going to summarize it and complete this topic. From where do valid instruments come from? Sometimes it seems an impossible task, but with the help of economic theory, statistical theory, natural experiments, clever thinking, hard thinking, you may get instrumental variable. I am going to tell you a very interesting story that how Snow discovered cholera using instrumental variable. Basically, he has used his shoe leather to discover cholera, but later on we find that there was use of an instrumental variable. That will be my next slide. Please be with me. So if your troublesome variable is measured with an error, but it does not change ranking of your explanatory variable, you can use it as, you can use rank variable as an instrument, because it will be correlated with X, but it will not be correlated with U. If you have leg of Y as endogenous variable and X is not troublesome, you can you may use leg of X as an instrument if X is determinant of Y. In wage equation, you may use distance to nearest college as instrument, because we see that if more education leads to more earnings, but more education is linked with ability. Ability leads to more education, ability leads to more wages. So distance to nearest college may lead to have more education, and it is not related with your ability. Similarly, you can have class size. Similarly, does putting more people in prison leads to lowering crime rate? That is a question which only economists ask. Please be with me for this next slide. That's very interesting one. That is how Snow discovered cholera. You see, in mid 19th century. There was a prevalence of cholera, and there is a story of London cholera epidemic. So, cholera, is it a function of water purity? But water purity in itself is related with your poor environment, with garbage in streets, rodents, and many other things. And it was assumed before Snow that it is basically miasma, human secretions, which basically leads to more cholera, and it's not water purity, or it has nothing to do with water. So you see, water purity in itself is related with other factors. What are the conditions of your community and all that. What did Snow do? Snow basically took two water companies providing water to London city, and from Thames River, he took Lambeth, which was located at upper part of Thames River, taking neat water, clean water, whereas Southwark was taking water from the part where you have sewerage and all other garbage going on. So he basically assumed that since water is a main culprit for cholera, so he took a large sample, about 300,000 household samples. Their other characteristics were not linked with water water quality. So they were randomly distributed. So those who were taking water from Lambeth, they have low prevalence of cholera than those who were taking from Southwark. So he concluded that this is basically water quality which leads to more cholera. Water is the reason for cholera prevalence. How we use the instrument, let's see. So we see that bad quality water and other factors are correlated, so therefore expected value of epsilon given B not equal to 0. So as a result, when we say that B is equal to 1, if good quality 0, otherwise beta 1, and here you don't have any variable, expected value of B equal to 1, B equal to 0. When you take this difference, that is low poor quality, good quality, you get this beta 1 is the difference between bad water and good water, but this coefficient, this term is not equal to zero, which means this is biased one. So therefore, this probability of cholera given water is good minus probability of cholera given water is bad may be linked with some other factors. So how to control that? That was the name of the game used by Snow. So he took basically an instrumental variable. If water is from Lambeth, if water is from Southwark, so he basically it means those quality of water from Lambeth is not the same as quality of water from the Southwark, and then he used this expected value of cholera given L equal to beta naught expected value of bad water given L company expected value of this one. So if L is 1, so since other factors have nothing to do whether you are taking water from Southwark or you are taking, this is Lambeth, whether you are taking from Lambeth or you are taking from Southwark. So what happens, expected value of cholera given you are taking from Lambeth, expected value of cholera you are taking it from Southwark, and this will be zero, this will be zero. So therefore you will find out, you can work it out. These slides are from Econometric Analysis, William Green. You can download expected value of this difference. So this term will become zero. So we have coefficient equal to beta 1, that is covariance between cholera and whether you take from Lambeth or you take from Southwark, covariance of bad quality water whether you take it from Lambeth or you take it from Southwark. And it was discovered that those who are taking water from Lambeth, they are basically they have very low prevalence of cholera than those who are taking from Southwark. And that's how Snow discovered that it's the water which is the main cause for cholera. Another interesting example is cardiac catheterization. Those who get cardiac catheterization, whether they survive more number of days than those who don't get. But you see, usually healthy patients get cardiac catheterization than who are more than weaker patients. So whether it's the healthy patients who will survive for more number of days, whether they have cardiac catheterization or not, as compared to those who are not healthy, or is it cardiac catheterization which leads to more survival? So this one is linked with your health and other factors. So therefore, this is not exogenous. So what's how we can find it out? Someone has done it in a very clever way. The distance to cardiac catheterization hospital may be considered as an instrument, because if you have nearby cardiac catheterization, if you go there immediately you will have cardiac catheterization. If distance is more, you may go to regular hospital. So it was considered, the instrument was used, that distance between regular hospital and cardiac catheterization, because whether you are healthy, whether you are not healthy, once you have cardiac problem, so if cardiac catheterization hospital is not nearby, you will go to regular hospital. So you will not get cardiac catheterization, whereas the other person who is living to this CC hospital may go to this CC hospital. And so you can compare those who go to CC hospital and those who don't, who go to real regular hospital. You can find out whether it's cardiac catheterization which leads to more number of survival days or not. So similarly, you can have crowding out of private charitable spending, whether when government spends more, then whether it leads to crowding out of private charitable. You can read these papers, this NBR working paper. And similarly, you have basically another one, whether school competition leads to is good for does competition amongst public school benefit students and taxpayers. You can read this paper and find out how these small streams in metro areas are used as instruments, because small streams basically geographically determine the boundaries of those the metro areas. So instrumental variable, if I summarize, there are two main points. Basically, there are three things. First is that we need to disentangle that part of X which is uncorrelated with U, and then we use it for determining Y. The relevance and exogeneity variable, relevance is tested by F test, exogeneity by J test. A valid instrument divides X into two parts, X hat plus U hat, but you must use your hat. Omitted variable bias, measurement, selection, simultaneous causality bias, all these things we have discussed time and again. So what is the list of threats, two threats, the assumptions which are used, and finally, whatsoever you do, there will be always criticism and your instruments may be disputed. So validity of instruments, interpretation of instrumental estimates, and all that must be done with great care. And instrumental variables should not be explanatory variables. I hope if you watch video number 29 to this video number 35, you'll have a reasonable understanding of instrumental variables. For more details, you can if you want to do advanced level, then this one I shall suggest William Green Econometric Analysis book. Thank you. Take care.